My name is Rick Miller. I am a lens-based artist. I'm a photographer and a filmmaker. My piece is called Calendar. It's a series of collages looking at how the pandemic has affected me and my family over the last 12 months. Calendar is looking in broadly at two themes. It looks at time and it looks at death. For myself and for many people, time moved rather slowly in the last few months, last 12 months or so. It certainly affected the way that I perceive the world when you can't get out into the world very much. Living with mental illness as I do, my perception of time is often distorted and it seems to stretch sometimes to a standstill and then shatter into a chaotic mess. And certainly in the midst of a pandemic, my perception of time has been vastly distorted. So we'll look at how my perception of time has changed over the progression of the pandemic. And death. My mother passed away in the middle of the pandemic. So I'm looking at how my family dealt with her death and with the aftermath of her death, how we try to move forward from that. When I got the commission, I knew immediately that I'd have to deal with my mother's death. I've been documenting her for decades, really. Creating Calendar has been a cathartic process for me because it's really helped me through the grieving process. It's helped me understand the importance of my mom in my life, and it's helped me come to terms with her death. It is a cathartic exercise. It's allowing me to re-examine my relationship to my mother. It's allowing me to re-examine my relationship with my family. And it's allowing me to re-examine my own relationship with death. Being somebody who lives with suicidal thoughts, I think of death quite a bit. Some of us die before our time. Some of us live long lives and die peacefully. You know, my mom's in there somewhere. It's been a wonderful way to pay tribute to my mom, and it's been a wonderful way to help me through the grieving process. This theme of trying to understand the complexity of emotions we're all experiencing during the pandemic is a vital one. Workman Arts is a community, and we get together and we talk about how we feel. When we can't get together, there's no ability to interact, to share these complex feelings, frustration, anger, depression, and at the same time, hope and creative energy that we get out of our everyday experiences. When that's taken away from us, we feel lost. So the show is a way for us to recreate that group energy that Workman is so wonderful at and tell the world that even though we are living under a pandemic, we're still creative individuals and we still have the ability to try to take understanding out of chaos. I work with cameras, I work with a smartphone, I work with a DSLR, I work with video cameras. I work with lens-based media because that's the tool I found early on in life to express myself. I don't write very well, I can't draw, I can't sculpt, but I can point a camera at something. I also found early on that I could express emotion through my photographs, express emotion through my filmmaking. So I turned to filmmaking and photography as a way to help me deal with depression, as a way to help me deal with anxiety. And it allows me to take abstract concepts like feeling anxious and turn that into a photograph. I've found a healing process. You know, being able to create keeps me sane. I don't know where I would be if I didn't have a little smartphone camera with me all the time. It's a therapeutic tool for me. The loss of a physical exhibition space really changes the way that I'm approaching the piece. You know, I usually think in grand terms of nice big pictures, of beautiful colors. I imagine people wandering through the show and talking to each other about the pieces and me being able to interact with them. Of course, we can't do that anymore. The idea of getting a bunch of people together frightens me. I'm scaling down. The pieces are physically smaller and I'm making pieces that are perhaps a more emotionally compact, that don't have a big emotional message. They've got one small compact message somebody can read in an instant, looking on their laptop, looking on their smartphone. We are going to be online, so it's going to be available to so many more people. Change brings the possibility of improvement in our lives. So maybe this will bring us a wider audience. I hope people seeing my piece understand that death has an effect on individuals, on families, on communities. And I also hope that people find a way to express their own feelings about this, not through anger, not through pity, but through creativity, that they're inspired to do their own pieces. This is my small contribution towards understanding what COVID-19 has done to the world.